Hey everybody, here is side B of the previous update I last posted of Ignorant Bliss. And I don't really have that much to say for this intro. Much of what I said last time, just a nice conversation, drinking happened, complaining about rappers and Kardashians happened. Colorism was talked about, stuff like that. You can also reach me at ignorantblisspodcast@gmail.com, on Twitter, Instagram, all that type of stuff, at Julian Lytle. The website for the podcast is ignorant-bliss.com. You can check out my stuff, my art stuff, when I decide to post it at thejulianlytle.com. You know, leave a review on iTunes. This is on Stitcher, Google Play, SoundCloud. I'm probably going to try to start putting stuff on MixCloud also. So, many ways for you to listen to it. I hope you enjoy. And peace.
Don't bother me, I'm working. Don't bother me, I'm working. Don't bother me, I'm working. Don't bother me, working. Let me, I'm working. Don't bother me. Don't bother me, can't you see? Don't bother me, working. Let me, I'm working. Don't bother me. Don't bother me, can't you see? Don't bother me, working. For me, I'm working. Don't bother me. Don't bother me, can't you see? Don't bother me, working. For me, I'm working. Don't bother me. Don't bother me, can't you see? Don't bother me, working. For me, I'm working. Don't bother me. Don't bother me. Can't you see? Don't bother me. Working. For me, I'm working. Yo.
Don't bother me. Don't bother me. Can't you see? Don't bother me. I'm working. Don't bother me. I'm working. Don't bother me. I'm working. Don't bother me. I'm working.
Can't you see I'm on the phone, bitch gone? Don't be coming over here with that shit when I'm working. Call me Mr. Combs and I'm 9 digits strong. Niggas hating on me, but it's not working. When I was 19, I walked in the house and I told my mama she could stop working. When you niggas used to beatbox on the block, Big and D-Rock, they was getting that working. Then I linked up with some niggas from my hood who was known for putting that working. And if your record ain't had nah, then your song wasn't working. Ran into this young Joan, tell her come home. She asked for a check, I said, bitch, is you working? Now every time she call, I don't even pick up, I just hit her with the text line.
Don't bother me, I'm working. Don't bother me, I'm working.
Yeah, put your hands together.
Don't bother me, I'm working. Don't bother me, I'm working.
Yeah, I ain't finished.
Don't work.
I do this shit for B.I.G. So if you don't like me, fuck you in the building you work. If you see us in the club with some.
Man, you're killing me though. That was like 3 classes you said like you've never seen.
What's another classic?
What's that? You ever seen Tombstone?
No.
Has the best Val Kilmer performance ever.
I'm not gonna argue with you because I don't know no other Val Kilmer performances.
I know mad Val Kilmer movies.
Have you seen Tombstone?
No.
Mm-hmm. Man.
Definitely not all the way through.
It's so gangster. That is a dude movie though. It's cowboys. It's a western.
What's that Will Smith western movie? That
Wild,
was a western.
Wild West.
Yeah, terrible. So I saw that. So I don't think because I haven't seen Tombstone that I'm not up on my Wild Wild West movies. Because I am.
It's not Tombstone though.
Goodfellas. Damn. Damn, no Goodfellas, huh? So you don't get the long take when he takes the young woman through the kitchen, through the side door, through the kitchen, and they bust out the table in the front of the Copacabana. He sits down. She's like, what do you do? Construction. It's like, boom. Oh, man. Woo. So much gangsterism in that.
Gangsterism.
That's that gangster shit right there.
Damn.
That's that real gangster shit. Damn. That's pure gangster shit, that movie. That's like...
I do like gangster movies, so perhaps I need to add that onto my list.
Robert De Niro, Joe Pesci.
Movies to watch.
Scorsese.
Do you want another artificially...
Artificial colored, orange cracker?
Yeah, colored cracker.
Don't taste like orange. Cracker.
My man Puffy still putting out music. Puff Daddy and the family.
Yeah, he's back to Puffy.
Yeah. I ain't never stopped calling him Puffy, to be honest.
So apparently he had a mixtape, right? Came out on his birthday.
Money Making Mitch. Which is a reference to Paid in Full, which you just said you watched.
That was Cam?
Yeah. Well, that wasn't his character. Kyle Pfeiffer's character was Mitch.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of childhood, favorite rapper of my childhood was definitely Cam Ryan. Huge Cam Ryan fan.
Did you wear pink like Cam too?
Well, this was before. This was like Confessions of Fire Cam. This was Entertainment Cam.
Yeah.
Way before all the pink stuff.
I love the pink stuff. That was gangsta.
Hmm.
I mean, people started rocking it in New York for sure. Like,
I remember.
And in the Midwest, people was fucking with Cam.
Did he bust out the Purple Haze?
Okay, Purple Haze.
Who was your favorite rapper?
As a child?
Child, teenager. We can go with it all.
It was Biggie when I was a teenager.
Mm-hmm.
Then as a early 20s, it became Jay-Z.
Mm-hmm.
It probably still is Jay-Z.
Okay.
He gives me motivation. Standards in which to reach. Get this money. When I want to get this money, I go to some classic Jay-Z. Young man Jay-Z. Ages 26 to 32 Jay-Z.
Gotcha.
That Reasonable Doubt to like the Blueprint.
Oh my God.
That's a young man when he was a philandering, womanizer, and hustler.
In his lyrics.
In real life, too.
What was the.
I was in New York at the time.
What was the MTV Unplugged Blueprint? Was that Blueprint?
Yeah.
2?
Nah, it was Blueprint 1.
It might have been in between the two, though.
Nah, it came out right after
Blueprint
the
Blueprint songs,
film.
Right?
Yeah. Boy.
It came out right
now,
after
as a female, and I know y'all think like females like sing songy songs, blah, 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 but as a female, like
as
Blueprint.
Women.
Female woman, damn. As a woman, Blueprint spoke to my soul.
What, because he was so honest on it?
It was so honest, and it just was like the right mix of like realness, like what y'all dudes be doing, right? And then just like, you know, kind of the grittiness. That was one album that I could play straight through. And then when he came out with the Unplugged and had Jaguar right on,
she was saying.
Dumb.
The roots here, that was
dumb.
It.
It was stupid. Like, when I still think about, like, one of my favorite albums, it's not Blueprint. It's Blueprint Unplugged.
It's Unplugged, though.
Yeah.
Mm. But now, growing up, I will say Master P was my favorite.
That was your dude.
That's my dude.
From
Lexington, Kentucky to Louisville. Like I said, when they called out Lexington, being from Lexington, Kentucky, that was the first time I ever heard my city in a song. So people who were from like the Phillies, the New Yorks, the DC, blah, blah, blah.
But
you guys.
DC had go-go music. Now I'm getting those.
But
I don't really
okay, but still, but that's still, true. You all had folks. You all had things to be proud of. In Lexington, we have the Kentucky Wildcats. And that's it. We don't have any professional teams. We don't have anything else to stand by besides our collegiate basketball
yeah.
team.
I've been
that being
once,
said,
it's just mass stores for that college team.
That's all we got. Stores. That's all we have. We don't have any professional teams. We don't have anything else to like stand on. So when P came up with Batty Batty saying Lexington, Kentucky to Louisville, you know they bowed it.
Yeah.
We was like, yes! Yes, we are.
Like, we bowed about it.
We bowed about it. He doesn't understand. Like, that made a huge difference in, like, feeling like we was finally getting called out.
That's people good at. Southern rappers are really good at calling out a lot of places just from their touring and going around, just calling out spots and ain't getting no love.
Yeah.
I will say that, but I don't think all Southern rappers kind of want to identify with the South, right? So even like Outkast, they had a great sound, but they, and we knew they were from Atlanta, but yeah, they still weren't on this, like, we gonna call them out type thing.
Yeah, it was just, they went, they started one way and then they kind of just went.
Yeah,
they on an artistic path of,
exactly, and that's okay too. That's okay too. But there's a certain amount of grittiness, right, that we have in Lexington that Cincinnati, Ohio has, which in Cincinnati is like an hour away. That is not, I mean, that no one ever thinks about or considers, right? Like, it's a rough life. It's gangs. It's this. It's that.
Well, Cam'ron, you say he get it in Ohio, so.
That's what I'm saying, but people don't really give that type of credence or understand, like, they think about it being like a country or like, you know, Middletown, USA type of feel when you think about Cincinnati, or like, okay, that's the Midwest. Like, everything, like, things are innocuous there. Like, they ain't got no struggle.
Ain't gangster.
Right, they ain't gangster. That's exactly what I'm saying. And I don't think people really recognize the things that we were going through. So when, like, a P came down, I think it was also like Trick at one point in time, has, we was like, yes, you get it. You
crib.
Right? Like, you get that we do go through these things. And it's not, you know, a lot of times when I meet people from Lexington or meet people outside of Lexington, they like, oh, you know, where the horses are, or where, like, it's automatically this thought that, like, we don't deal with anything, and then it's a country town as opposed to, like, a town where urban things occur.
I'm not saying I wasn't guessing it,
but you know what I mean? Like, yeah, there, like, it's hard knock lives there, too.
There's a hood everywhere. I know that's for sure.
That's real.
And when Mia X, right? So I'm gonna tell you,
Mia X,
absolutely, because she gets no credit. So when I talk about Master P, like, as an extension of Master P, Mia X was a person that, like, I would write down her lyrics. The Biggest Mama, you know, Mia X, like, I would be rapping her lyrics, and I thought, like, I so identified with her, the way that she rapped, like, the her Southern, like, even the intonation. It's just, I don't know. It's one of those things that I really feel like people don't get just the influence that No Limit Southern rap had on people that weren't from, like, NOLA and stuff like that in the lesser known cities.
Yeah, I think it's probably got a lot taken over because of Cash Money blew up.
Yeah.
And they stayed around.
Kind of swallowed that up.
And then,
But when they swallowed it up, like, think about the women.
Going to jail.
Yeah, but think about the women that they then empowered, right? So, like, when you think about Cash Money, you think about Nicki Minaj as an extension of Cash Money, right? Like, yeah, on Young Money. She from New York, though.
She from Queens.
Like, when I think about Mia X, when I think about, who was it? Sons of Funk, like, the different people on No Limit, those folks were like, they were like a family. They were all, like, in the NOLA Southern folks. It wasn't like this conglomerate of folks from, like, Toronto or from New York or, like, this or that. Like, they were Southern-ass people.
I think when it was weird because for me, the biggest Southern artist I got to when I was younger was, besides Atlanta people, but it was like 8-Ball MJG.
Yes.
And then 3-6.
Yes.
And I remember because I was in New York when I really started getting into 3-6, and there's always this bias in New York against rappers from outside. Really, it's like it took them a while to even respect LA.
Mm-hmm.
And then at that time, they still wasn't really respecting Atlanta. And then so they damn sure wasn't respecting nobody from Memphis, Tennessee, and the Texas, and all that. So it was weird because I was like, I had to, like, unlearn the biases, because when I come home, all the people in D.C. was listening to nothing but, like, 3-6 back then.
Really?
Yeah, D.C. fucked with the Southern rap heavy. It was like, you would think they would go heavy for New York, it's to a certain degree, like, certain people, but really, like, when I grown up, a lot of people's favorite rappers was the Ghetto Boys.
Really?
Like,
the Ghetto Boys, like, that's West Coast.
Nah, they from Texas.
Yeah, from,
You know, I don't know why. Yeah. I always thought of them as, like, West Coast rappers.
Because I think it came out an era where the only other rappers besides New Yorkers were from the West Coast. They came out so early in the game.
Okay.
So, but yeah, like, you know, it's something hidden. And, like, that's when, like, I met people from down south, and I got a friend My man Lexi from Florida used to put me on a screw tapes, and then that gone into a deep pit of music listening I've been doing the last 15 years.
You still on screw music right now?
Yeah, that Wicked album just came out chopped up this week. I heard the hills for like 1 minute. I almost fell on my seat like Fred Sanford. I was like, ooh.
You're gonna have to give your listeners some of that though, seriously.
Not the same, I am too reckless. I'm not trying to go in that direction. These niggas, they've been doing too much flex. They about to call the wrong answer. And I don't got no patience, no more test. I do shit how I want, don't need no bless. XO niggas ain't nothing to mess with. Nobody stopping us from what we destined. And everybody around you is so basic. I'm never rocking white, I'm like a racist. I don't drink my liquor with a chasing. Now money is the only thing I'm chasing. And some dope dimes on some coke lines. Give me head all night, come 4 times. Baby girl just wanna smoke a pound. Do an ounce, get some dick, tell the friends about. Baby girl just wanna smoke a pound. Do an ounce, get some dick, tell the friends about. Baby girl just wanna smoke a pound. Do an ounce,
get some dick. Ooh, I don't even know I ain't tweet about that yet. I was like, oh.
Heard Joe, you sure you're not on drugs, man?
You on
this perp
or not?
Nah, I'll make that perp. I joke about it.
Have you ever thought about how different your life would be if you were on drugs?
Yeah.
Because
I had similar thoughts like that.
Nah, I probably wouldn't be as I don't think I would be as irresponsible or the person that I am now. I don't think it would be good. So yeah, But man, I'd be listening to that chopped up music though. I'd be listening to that lean induced music.
I like that with weed music.
There's a lot of weed.
With what? Weed music?
Weed music, but I don't smoke.
Who do you consider to be
like
weed?
Like Wiz Khalifa smoked, there's a...
Yeah, they just rap about
weed. They just rap about smoking weed.
Mm.
Whole albums about smoking weed. See, Currency.
The thing with like with chopped up music is they're not really rapping about it, but it just seems like you listen to the album regular and it's good, but then you hear it chopped up and you're like, oh shit, this is what is his real intention.
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest though, the only chopped music that I like really like speaks to my soul, and maybe it's because I'm a slow jam connoisseur, are slow jams. Like, I get it. Like, I've heard it, like, in so many other, in, like, you know, in the rap medium. But when I hear some Isley Brothers chopped and screwed, I'm done. Like,
so
I'm done. Can you cue that up for your audience?
Yeah.
Will you go through that? sheets on if you don't mind. Like, I just screw. Okay.
This is like, I don't know what y'all talking about, but yeah,
I know what y'all, I just haven't heard it.
But chopped up though.
Jesus. That, like, I mean, somebody gonna make a baby off of your podcast. It's gonna be somebody's illegitimate bastard child.
You gonna hear it? They gonna look it up. You like, y'all don't know what y'all doing. Man. Like, do you really want to go down this hole? Because this hole right here. Yeah, but, yeah.
You're going to be responsible for a child.
Yo. Like, there's a... Yeah, I still, like, I'm still downloading mixtapes. Like, they, that new kid, Brandon Tyson, did that song, Don't, or whatever. I don't know.
I haven't heard it.
He got his album, is called Trap Soul. But I ain't heard it yet. I saw they got a Chopped Up version called Chop Soul. I'm like, I'm just going to listen to Chopped Screw version. I'm not even gonna listen to the regular version.
Okay, you gonna go straight to the, you gonna dive in, like
purple
like,
version,
like Trey Songz, dive in. Okay, I wish the audience could see it just the way you decided to dive in. Like, he has motion, both like a backstroke, a front stroke, and like a deep dive.
Like, oh man, this is so much dope.
I can't.
But like, I'm literally so excited to listen to this weekend album, Chop This Groove. I have no idea. It's like, this moment, I'm like, whew, like, I know that's what I'm going to listen to all next week.
Interesting. Will you listen to that in the office in lieu of like, okay, well, you know, I may be listening to my gospel, but, yeah.
Because I'm so excited to hear Tell Your Friends Chopped Up, because that's like my favorite song on that album, because it's just fantastic.
What do you like about the song?
It's the production behind it, the sample that Mike Dean and the producer used, and the other producers used, and Kanye used on that song. A little bum 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 bum, and it just like, and he just sings like, yeah, and that shit, you know, that Billy Mee stuff that he's always talking about, how basically he doesn't care about nobody, but you know, he's just going.
He said, "F them hoes."
He says it in a sweet way, in not a way that's like, you really shouldn't be messing with me, because I'm not in a good place right now.
I tell you what, anytime someone sings in either an alto or a falsetto, it don't matter what you say. Like, The Weeknd is the same way. He be, or I'm sorry, not The Weeknd, The Dream. He'll talk about like beating a woman, but he sings it in falsetto, and I'm like, oh, you gonna pull somebody's hair? Like, okay, like, but the falsetto sounds so good that you, honestly, you gloss right over the violence. You're like, oh, okay, that's cool.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So maybe I need to listen a little more closely to what The Weeknd is saying.
It's not that he's talking about, like, you really hurt nobody. He's really kidding, like, he's just, The Weeknd album is honest. It just, it's really, like, really pop right now, because that's where he chose the one to go. But it's still the same thing he's been always singing about. He's like, I'm kind of broke inside. So you come along with this ride, you're going to get hurt.
You cool with that?
You
I just on. Like, you make it sound like, I'm imagining him singing like Dr. Evil quotes.
Like, come on.
Petting a cat.
If one of the his most popular, the song The Hills, right? He's like,
that's what the cat is. Like, pets the
it's kind of like that, but like, come on, The Hills. I only call you when it's 5:30. Like, that's kind of fucked up. Like, I only like call
AM
you.
AM or PM?
He's talking about AM, because he's like, I just spent out all night.
He said, let me give you my leftovers, my crumbs.
Yeah. Like, I'm going to call you at 5:30 in the morning after I done been out already. I done already parted. He done had so much, he's like, I already slept with two other chicks tonight, so it was good. Like, it was like, that's in the lyrics. What? That song is amazing. The Hills is amazing.
Your man on the road, he doing promo. You said keep our business on the low, low. I'm just trying to get you out the friend zone, 'cause you look even better than the photos. I can't find your house, send me the info. Driving through the gated residential, found out I was coming, sent your friends home. Keep on trying to hide it, but your friends know.
I only called you when it's half past, but the only time that I'd be by your side, I only love it when you touch me. Now feel me when I'm fucked up, that's a real me. When I'm fucked up, that's a real me, yeah. I only called you when it's half past, but the only time I'd ever call you
I ain't even listen to the remix. He got a remix with like Nicki Minaj and Eminem. I ain't even listen to that version. I'm like, what do y'all guys bring to this? It's already perfect. You guys are good rappers, but come on. What do you bring to this?
So is he your favorite artist right now? Is The Weeknd?
He might be my favorite singer.
The Weeknd?
Yeah, he might be my favorite singer right now. Oh, his stuff is hot this year.
I'm going to tell
He's
you.
He's having a good year.
He is having a good year. And earned it. I know it's so commercialized, but nah, when I heard that separate from like the 50 Shades of Grey sound, I said, Lord have mercy.
Yeah, that's when he took it to another level. It's like,
that's when it was next level.
He was like, yeah. I was like, and again, that's a
But now he wasn't misogynistic on that.
No, which is funny because from what I hear about the story of that it's just like
right,
a really
like
fucked up ass story.
I thought he could have went harder, but it was like one of those things where he's like, I'm gonna give you compliment after compliment.
He's like, I'm not gonna give you regular Weeknd, I'm gonna flip it because this story actually 50 Shades of Grey is regular the Weeknd, so I'm gonna give you a song that's not regular Weeknd. That's the way I took it. But yeah, that song is dope. The video is great too.
I didn't see the video.
See, I'll be watching that. I'll watch the video.
I didn't see the video. The video might have been too much for me.
Nah, it's just him chilling in a suit, and they got like these girls doing stuff, and it's just like, you know.
I mean, I'm just not, I'm really not interested in music videos these days. I never see anything different, right? I don't see anything that is like, I mean, really, music videos are anticlimactic, all of them. It's like, I see you singing the song. Well, what difference does it make, right? You got a couple of girls, it's like maybe body rolling in the back.
Well, sometimes you gotta look at genres outside of like rap or whatever. They got more interesting videos. But actually, most of the Weeknd's videos have like these grand connecting stories as of late. I'm just saying.
No.
Kendrick Lamar's videos is pretty interesting. Especially like the...
I just think given the budget as of late, like people can't do a whole lot. And some of the... I just find to be kind of trite. Like, it's like these storylines that are like... would make for a bad movie sequence, right?
Yeah. Like, look at this Post Malone video. I like this song by Iverson, but this video is kind of bad.
Right. He in his dirty ass t-shirt.
He is.
With these dirty ass braids in the desert doing willies, you know what I mean? Kicking up dust. Now, when do you know people are out there like... It's just unbelievable.
This video is really silly to watch for those now.
I've never seen shit in my life. Who is this person?
Post Malone has that song called White Iverson.
And I just want Post Malone to redo his braids.
So essentially it's a song basically wanting to be like Allen Iverson.
Iverson got his braids redone every hour.
He never had dusty ass braids and never he always cleaned up his beard. So guess what? Post, you ain't gonna make it.
Yeah.
Post ain't gonna make it, man. Two thumbs down.
And you done found a white... Basketball, like, come on. What's the talk about white
rappers though? As a collective,
who do you want to talk about though?
Easy was on all of them
as a group.
What's okay, your
on white rappers.
Machine Gun Kelly. Who else?
I don't know no Machine Gun Kelly songs. I don't have a beef with Machine Gun Kelly. I feel like he's in his lane and he stays in it.
What's his lane?
Whatever he does.
Somewhere between punk and rap.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Because he can have all that. He can have that.
Repping his city.
But what about like Iggy Azalea, right?
We can't.
I mean, we'll just use her as the example for what I'm talking about. Because you don't have to talk about her, but we'll use her as the example for what we're talking about. Well, what I'm talking about, which is where she has X speaking voice and then Y rapping voice.
The white people rap, huh?
Yo. I want to cover all white people in the same blanket. It's not about them being white. It's about the culture. It's about you being of the culture. You don't have to be a black person to be of the culture. But if you step into the culture and profit off the culture without adding anything, it's like gentrification, right? Like, I don't mind the whitening of the neighborhood, but add to the neighborhood and the residents that are there. Don't push them out. They don't profit off of the work they put in that they're not making money on. Just like we talked about with Twitter. Like, you don't own it. You're driving it, but what good is it doing you if you don't own it, if you aren't benefiting from the work you're putting into it?
Yeah.
That's my problem with... It's not so much with rap music, but with as far as the musicians. But the money is being made by the execs. And that was illustrated no more clearly than in Straight Outta Compton. Like, they captured it perfectly.
Yeah.
Dude stepped in, he said, "I don't know anything about rap, but I know y'all gonna make a lot of money. And I want parts." That's all it was.
And I'd expand that. Like, I have an issue with anyone who makes money off of black culture, black men, black anything. I think that's why I have an issue with the Kardashians, why I have an issue with the Miley Cyrus of the world, with Iggy, whatever the hell her name is. There are several things that are outside of even just music that is really bothersome to me. I think the question is, and you put this quite well, like, what are you doing to then add to the culture? You want to take from the culture, you want to profit off the culture. How are you adding to it?
Can I ask a real ass question right now? Why do we have this problem with the Miley Cyrus and the Iggy Azalea and all those people you mentioned, but not with Drake?
Because he's black. He mixed, but he black.
You listen to Logic? Yeah. Kid from here, from Maryland?
Yeah, he's good.
He's pretty good.
Yeah.
Okay.
But he's like just as black, you know, like as Drake, as J. Cole. Like, they got like the black dad and the white mom, right?
Oh, he mixed?
Yeah.
I ain't know, like, he's mixed.
But he looks white.
He looks straight up. He look white like my man Lil Dicky right there.
He made this video for free.
I know. This song is fire.
The whole thing. He asked if he could use someone's house. Everything he's going to do. We don't know that.
Just to flex on him, we ain't really gotta lie, yeah. I'm a type of motherfucker that'll check the check, do the math, I ain't never getting robbed. Those margaritas not going on my card. I ain't about to split a damn thing for convenience sake. I'm at the restaurant working that way. Holla, you ain't heard a little day, young elder Jew, biz major. Fuck you know about the world he raised in. I've been saving money since a motherfucker 13. I wear the same pair of jeans every day. Sandwiches, homie, two stamps away. Book flight December, but I leave in May. Drugs are generic, but still work the same. I get logins for Netflix for my cousin Greg. Thanks, Greg.
That's what I got, nigga. All of my bitches be scared of me, I put that rod in them. All of them bitches acting thoughtless, I disregard them. All of them bitches acting holy, ain't got no God in them. I can teach a little nigga something like a preacher. I can take his ass to church, fresh as hell, no Easter. I can make his ass burp like a baby without no hiccup. I can.
Quan, what does this have to do with saving money, though? You know what? A full verse would have been too expensive, anyways.
I ain't parking at a less than meter grade, homie. Haircut several months in between, homie. Hit the motherfucking lights when I leave, homie.
Why is this shit cool?
Because, well, his entire album is a comedy rap album. Why it's cool.
Why is it cool to make a comedy rap album?
Let me tell you what's cool about it.
Because other people suck when they make comedy rap albums.
I'm gonna tell you what I like about this and where I think we stand to gain, like, as black people. Number one, I think Kanye put it best. Like, you get some money, you go buy some stuff you don't really need. This man is okay with saying, like, I ain't really worried about it. He said he has folks with money, but he doesn't need to ask them for it. Everything that he has in this video is something he's either asked to borrow or to use just for, you know what I mean, for the amount of time.
The name of the song is Save That Money. It's
and
the point
saved,
where he's like, I have to figure out to make... The whole connotation of the record is... going against, like, why are we
spending money on videos?
So that goes into
talking
the,
about why your thing is, why is he even critiquing?
That's exactly
why that's is he problem. As a white dude
now you
even
step
critiquing
into the culture?
Why are you critiquing us
and critique it and question things that are done and say, I have a better way of doing what you're doing? So that's like, oh, all of y'all are wrong for liking this.
That's a valid point because it's,
I don't know. Go ahead.
Because there's a point in which...
I want something like Lord Jamar.
No. In terms of, there's a point where I think he's actually a good rapper and I find his album hilarious. But there is a point where it can hit a tipping point where, like, T-Pain is letting him film parts of his video.
And T-Pain obviously paid like, for his video.
Yeah,
yeah. And you heard what I said? Who do I blame?
And then like,
who do I blame?
Rich Homie Quan is on the song, and Fetty Wap is on the song. So at a certain point, and there's a point in which he blows up with this rap of essentially not only making fun of his whiteness by saying, look at how frugal and stuff I am, or his white Jewishness of being, look at how frugal I am, blah, 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 but also critiquing art. That's like my problem I had with the Lord song, Royals. Mm-hmm. You really listen to the lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
She's critiquing hip hop, and it's just like, A, you're 17. B, how dare you critique people who never had shit, who gets to have shit, if you're going to talk about we finally got something.
And listen, I understand that. I think my one critique of this and what he's attempting to show is that I'm not sure that there is, I don't know what black man could walk up to someone's house in Bel Air and say, do you mind if I shoot a music video here? Rich Homie Quan, like, you know what I mean?
Check your it's a type of privilege
that you get that he's not acknowledging by saying, look at all the free stuff that I can get. And just I can have this just because people trust me with their stuff in a way they're never going to trust you with your stuff.
Yeah. Yo, fuck this dude. I can't even hear the song.
Like, he got Mark Cuban in there.
I can't even hear the song that I don't like.
It's such a funny song. But wait. What's up with Drake, though? What's your issues with Drake?
My issue with Drake
is pretty simple.
But he did have these white girls with little booties in here. I can respect that. Well, like, he went and got no big booty girl, black girls on here. He went and got some.
There was big booty black girls in the scene before this.
Where? I missed it.
That's from the T-Pain video.
That's from
the like, it's literally like all the black chicks are for other people's videos.
It ain't like he's slapping a black girl, big booty black girl. He done got some moderate size asses, and they are now, like, you know, part of his video.
Fuck this dude.
I didn't know that you were. You know what? You know what? Like, I know I called you an asshole earlier, and I meant it. But like this, you're redeeming yourself a bit by like being so militant.
I got five or six things in life I really care about, and you'll get me like railed up about them.
All right, let's go.
This is one.
Black culture. I want to hear this thing about the Drake though. I want to hear a real serious critique about. I love hearing his critiques about Aubrey. I like to call him by his mother.
I'm telling you right now.
His mother name Aubrey.
People got a problem with Iggy Azalea.
Okay.
Because she's from Australia and she speaks like an Australian person.
Okay.
But she raps with a black scent.
Okay.
You remember the black scent from Howard Stern? And he like, come on, he say, oh, I can't even do this shit. But white people do like an exaggerated black voice.
If you could, like, during this, when you're editing, go to the Dancing with Stars. Like, that whole clip. So she's like rapping in this black scent. Her mic messes up and she's like, guys, what happened? What the fuck? And it's like the juxtaposition between the two things just shows it, like, that ain't really you. Go find that clip. Please show your eyes.
Do you have a problem with that?
I do.
Drake does the same exact thing. The exact same thing.
Really? Except
he doesn't speak the same in the same voice. He raps like he's from Memphis.
Or from Houston.
Your dad's
from depending on the song he's on, he'll rap like he's from Atlanta.
But he does not speak like that. I don't necessarily feel that way. One, because I don't feel like he's a hard rapper. I think Iggy Azalea, with her mannerisms, with her like her intonation, like all of those things, is like,
why don't like, get an injury? He does co-op flows and regions.
All of that.
Okay, but flows and regions, but there's enough diversity in them that it's not as if it's, for me, there's not that same hard line where I am purposely trying to act as if I am something that I'm not. I think what he has, many people have acknowledged, is that he's a soft rapper, right? I sing, I might do a hotline, like bling dance, like whatever else. He's never come off as the hardcore rapper. If he was someone trying to rap like a T.I. or something, I feel a certain way.
I'm not talking about his content. I'm not talking about his content at all. I'm talking about the way he sounds.
I just don't feel that way.
He raps like a black person from this area. And he is not that person. He speaks like a white person from Toronto.
Give me an example.
He speaks like he was raised by a Jewish mother in Canada. Like,
give me an example of a rap. I don't feel like he's a hardcore. He doesn't sound, even in his flow, he does not sound like a hardcore rapper.
I'm not talking about him being hardcore. I'm talking about him sounding like
But I would
people
say this,
from a region.
What about A$AP Rocky, who is from Harlem, New York, and sounds like he come from Houston? He raps like he's from Houston.
But this is why I would draw the distinction.
Or like a Fetty Wap.
This is why I draw the distinction with him as well. They don't change it up. They grew up listening to that music, and now they rap like that music.
You feel like
you think Drake didn't grow up listening?
Drake has switched it up. I remember Drake comeback season. First time I heard Drake was on a fucking Trey Songz track.
You going back? You going comeback season?
I first heard him on a Trey Songz track.
What was that song? Something Girl.
Replacement Girl.
Replacement Girl.
And I listened to it and I was like, this must be Trey Songz' whack homeboy.
Can you cue that up too? Because I don't even remember that song.
Best hook of all time on that song.
Replacement Girl.
So if you play it, enjoy the hook. Best hook of all time.
Let me show you what it is. I was birthed up top, but was raised at the bottom of the map where the girls all thick and the hottest to grab. If you're looking for the good, then we got him in a trap. Like, ooh-wee, took it from White Snakes to ooh-wee. This metaphor might sound a little confusing, but y'all really know how to come a long way from a day's end. And other hotels that I stayed in, a simple lifestyle from mediocre to good, and now we say it's sitting at amazing. Girls trying to soho lobby us, hear them all screaming, and it's probably us. But I can't blame females, females can't really ignore something that's obvious. What you really expect when I strut through town? 2 or 3 days, I shut you down. Chilling with the homie Trey Songz, you call him a prince. Here at 2 up, 2 down. Anyone I know get used to me. I'm far from the man that I used to be. And I don't ever really kick game. I know you find it impressive whenever you introduce to me. Cause I'm a good dude, take pride in that. Need good love and I'm providing that. Understand that I'm worldwide, you get it how you want it, wherever you be residing at. Cause I do things from the M-Town to the UK and from Spain back out to Texas. This album for my fans, but yo, this hook is for my exes.
This one is for you, girl. You know who you are, girl. Only show your face, cause you know that I'm a girl. But you're trying to make it, don't ever mistake it. Girl, my time is limited, I ain't trying to waste it all on you.
You had your chance, now it's gone.
It's gone for you.
You had the main, now you don't.
Now you don't. Back to the basics, I think I made it. Now just make some noise if you wanna be my replacement, girl.
Ain't you never seen a youngin' so fly?
Probably not.
Looking for something your type. I'd left behind the love of my life. Trying to find another one tonight. And if it's you, baby, let yourself be seen.
Don't matter, skirts.
Trey Songz, I was like, this must be Trey's whack homeboy who just said, yeah, I'll give you a verse. We're gonna skip it every fucking time, but you can have.
Do you mind
verse.
If we listen? Can I pull that up? Because I gotta remember to
but
be able to intelligently comment.
Then from there, I heard him on a track with Little Brother. And he was rapping like he was a backpacker from North Carolina.
Yeah, because he was a fan.
And then I heard him on a track with Elzai. And he was rapping like he was a backpacker from Detroit. And then I heard him on a track with Lil Wayne.
And he was rapping also like sober
Lil Wayne.
And he was rapping Wayne then too. So yeah. He's
come
able
on,
to borrow flow, so there's a point in which he sounds just like Kirk Cobain's. There's a period which he's just straight up.
Or the Migos. Look at, like people are finally calling him out on it now because they're like, oh, you jumped on a Migos song and then you did 6 songs like the Migos and then, like, you know, borrowed their wave.
But you can say this somewhere. The thing is that what people didn't like to talk about if you listen to Gangsta Boo is that Migos flow is Lord Infamous flow from 3-6.
Uh-huh.
So they ain't create that flow.
Yeah, I mean, no, it's new.
But
it's not new on this song.
But that's true. But he took the thing is, they benefited greatly off of him.
Explain to me how that's different from what Iggy Azalea does by rapping like she's from Atlanta and speaking like she's from Australia. And not even just rapping like she's from Atlanta, but intentionally co-opting the most stereotypical aspects of being a female rapper from Atlanta.
I think it's...
And how is that different from what Drake does?
So perhaps it's different. Like if Iggy picked up several different ways and mannerisms, like if it wasn't just like, I'm going to be this hardcore rapper from Atlanta. If it were, I'm going to be this surfer girl from... Like, in a similar way that Miley Cyrus is, right? Like, people don't go as hard on Miley Cyrus because she has shown herself to be a chameleon as they go on Iggy Azalea, who has shown herself to be like, I'm going to particularly try to be one particular way. In the same way, Drake has, if I concede with your conclusion that he's definitely picked up in attempts to be like different types of folks within like whatever genre is hot at the time, like he's been several different people. He's not trying to act as if he is all of one way. And Iggy has. Does that make sense?
I know what you're saying. Yeah.
The thing of it is, he sings always the same way.
Right? And I just feel like...
When he decides to sing, it's always...
Because that's what
half really, his shit is
that's
singing.
Really what he was trying to do. He really wanted to come out here and sing.
Half his shit is singing. So yeah, so it's like...
I'm going to do this. This is my only request. Mount Olympus by Big Crit. Play that for the people, please.
Five albums, seeing a swirl, country niggas snap. Thought they wanted trap. Thought they wanted bass. Thought they wanted Miley. Thought they wanted Drake. Fuck them niggas, now they wanna hear a country nigga rap. Five albums, seeing a swirl, country niggas snap. Thought they wanted gold. Thought they wanted shine. Thought they wanted radio. Bitch, make up your mind. All this attention, I don't even know what I might do with it. That control beat is like a ugly bitch that everybody done fuck wrong. Maybe you hit it. Oh man, I'm more concerned why niggas been texting my cell, calling my phone, ask me about this kind of shit. They ain't even really diss me on, I ain't thrown all this
problem. Play that song for the people, and I want the people to know there's a particular section in that song that is about Drake. If it's not specifically about Drake, when Big Crit wrote it, he's referring to Drake. And that's really my thesis. That section of Mount Olympus is my thesis. But we can take another place where we take the white dudes straight out of Compton, for example, right? White dude says, I don't know anything about rap, but I know y'all gonna make a lot of money, and I wanna be behind it so that I can, you know, get 85% of that.
I ain't mad at Drake.
What if that same white dude could just put his son out there and get 100%?
Why does your hat go higher into the side when you feel like...
When I feel like...
like you feel like you've gotten gangster,
like, as
right?
My... No, as my
like
words
so
get bigger.
It's like, so funny.
It's about where my words get bigger, like T.I. It's like a T.I. thing.
Where did this come
it's like,
from?
Yeah, it's like
right
a
now.
T.I. Like,
you came in,
your
fit
words
a cap,
get
it's like super down.
And your hat goes like... You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
That's it, serious business.
It's like I turned to Clifford.
This is why, like... I wish that your show was recorded, like, video. Full body, yeah, it was video, yeah. I really wish, because folks need to see, like, this whole transition.
Like, the animation. I don't get animated often, so, yeah, I feel you.
But, yeah, that current criticism you have of the
people like just now.
But it's been something that, what gets him by is his use of melodies, his use of...
Yeah, good music.
Like, the song is like, there's a certain point where I was like, I don't know about Aubrey. And then there was one point where I got to take care, I'd be like, all right. But there was a certain point where it's just like when you first heard, if you're reading it, so it's already too late. The beginning of the album, the first song, Legend.
I love this song.
He's a good song.
He's rapping straight like Kurt Cobain. And then it's half the song, it's Party Next Door. So Party Next Door is on the album. Party Next Door got his own lanes, but when they're together, Drake essentially becomes Party Next Door. Or when he's with The Weeknd, he can't actually totally do The Weeknd, because The Weeknd is that singular of an entity that, like, you can't really copy him. So, but it's exactly what you're saying. He's able to do that, like, well. That's his skill. His skill is to completely change. Because, let's be honest.
Is that a real skill?
Modern Drake.
That's not a real skill.
In terms of selling shit, is. His modern Drake.
No, you just are marketable.
Yeah, Drake's skill, Drake, is, as we is a perfected version of 808s and Heartbreak. It's like, if 808s and Heartbreak...
Polished version.
Yeah, if 808s and Heartbreak was a Pokemon, that motherfucker's Charizard of that shit. Like, Kanye put this out, like, I was hurt. I made this dope-ass album that I really shouldn't be singing on, but I got it out of me.
Is that a good thing? Is 808s and Heartbreak supposed to be polished?
No.
Because if you ask me the perfected, if you ask me the perfected version, it's Kid Cudi. And Cudi is not polished at all. Yeah. He's entirely emotional.
Especially Man on the Man 1 and 2.
Right.
Ooh,
entirely expressive and emotional. So if I come to you and I'm like, oh, I'm a polished version, a cleaned up version of 808s and Heartbreak, like, that's not what it's supposed to be. You just monetize, you commercialize it.
He made it into pop, the pop version of it. He's a pop artist. Aubrey Drake Graham is a pop artist.
I agree 100%.
He makes some great pop music. But I'm never putting him as like, yo, he's one of the best rappers ever.
He's not.
Nah.
He's not a rapper.
This is like, hey, I listen to hell out of his music. Sounds great through the chop.
If you think about what certain rappers, particularly like the most talented of them, right? What they put their white rich execs
it
through.
It really is.
To
Do you
get the
hear
money.
Anything else?
I'm sure right now. I mean, yeah, you could just
one wish, though. This just came out. Lord Jesus, we talking about Ray J and his messed up ass.
I fucks with Ray J.
Ray J, I don't fuck with
Ray J. Ray J is a funny dude, yo. You remember when he told me, he said he's gonna send some dudes to rape Fabulous?
He said booty goons. He said I'm gonna send some booty goons.
Who, Ray J? Ray J,
he said he was gonna send some.
Indoor pool and an outdoor pool.
You mean Moesha little brother?
He got an indoor basketball court and an outdoor basketball court.
Moesha little brother?
Yes, he said.
Brother.
He said he's going to send some booty goons to Ray. Fabulous. F-A-B-O-L-O-U-S.
Fabulous from Brooklyn, New York.
I just spelt it.
See,
for
I gotta turn it. I gotta turn it to Vince Staples or y'all that like now. You like keeping up with the Kardashians? You like Kanye West? You like For the Love of Hip Hop?
Ray J. We wouldn't have that.
Oh, Ray J.
I wouldn't go to Kanye bar, but yeah, we're for Ray J. Kanye was already out there before Ray J got that sex.
Well, Ray J is connected. He's connected to all that.
Yes, that is true. And their issue with them too, because for some reason they only fuck rappers and basketball.
I mean, it was before he was famous.
I cannot. I cannot with the Kardashians. I cannot with the fact that Lamar Odom, and as basketball fans, you all should be saying something about this, that every time his name is mentioned, it is associated with Khloe Kardashian.
He's the first
this
Mr.
man,
or
crack cocaine.
I don't give a. Like, this man right here has a legacy that is outside of these hoes.
But he ruined it.
I don't care.
I don't care.
I don't find her to be relevant. Like, I do think that they... Let me tell you. I was praying for him to pull through, honestly, for two reasons. Number one, because I want him to live. Number two, because I hope he lives long enough to tell exactly what the hell they did to him. The fact that he had threatened, like, a long time ago, he said, y'all keep messing with me. I'm gonna tell the world what's really going on. They done messed some people up. And I have no doubt that Kris Jenner is the machine behind, like, oh, all the other stuff that's going on.
She's the biggest pimp of the last 20 years.
She is the biggest pimp. The fact that your daughter has a sex tape out and then you suggest to her, you suggest that she goes and then does a Playboy shoot. Well, on one hand, you just told her that she needs to clean up her image. On the other hand, you got her posing naked. What the hell is it? So the fact that then Lamar Odom, all of a sudden he says he starts having issues finding a team, like da 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 da. He's a dope athlete. Now, I don't doubt that he has his own issues and demons.
Crack cocaine.
I don't doubt that.
Hard to play basketball, you high on crack.
I hear you, but I do.
What got him on that crack, though?
Honestly, I don't know.
Said, like, people in his family, like, the drug thing goes deep from his neighborhood.
I think it does, but here's my thing. It was super convenient when the rest of the world knew about it. I think he's probably had drug issues from way back when. But all of a sudden, think about this. All of a sudden, when him and Khloe, it's time for a divorce or their divorce proceedings, all of a sudden, every demon and dark cloud in his background starts coming out. Now, all of a sudden, the media knows about this drug addiction, knows about that. You can't tell me that's nobody else but Kris Jenner trying to ruin his reputation and trying to give grounds for Khloe to divorce him and get hella money. I don't, like, it's sickening.
Well, it's kind of, if you look at it, it's like...
I can't.
Because even you think about what... Like,
you talk about things that get you hot, that gets me hot.
You look at Courtney's baby daddy, Scott. Like, he's fucked up in the game, too.
Is he?
Yeah, man.
He's a smart one.
He's crazy addicted. He got crazy, like, alcoholic problems and drug problems.
But here's what I'm saying. I'm not saying that these people...
What are they doing to these men in their lives?
What are they doing? And I'm not saying that these people don't have the issues. I'm just wondering if it's exacerbated and if it is publicized to the extent that there may be an issue and then it is made, number one, public. Like, you can't tell me that all of a sudden these people had issues. I think that you all hid the issues. And then when it was convenient for either divorce proceedings or child custody battles or whatever else, all of a sudden, the media starts giving these negative reports about their bad character traits. The same thing with Chris Humphries. He's all good. He's a, you know what I mean, a stellar man until Kim Kardashian don't want him no more. And then all of a sudden, he's this and he's that, every bad thing. Same thing with Hello? They full of shit. They full of shit. I can't.
He never got all the way in. So he's kind of straight now.
He's able to bounce out. He ain't get in like Lamar.
Right.
But you can't tell me. And I, like I said, I hope that he... I know that she's there for him now, right? And I almost wonder if it's like hush money.
Is she
like,
really? Is she really?
Okay, whatever.
She went to, because I say I saw she went to go visit James Harden.
Here's my thing. I think it, I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you. It's in her.
Get out of there, James, if you're listening.
Get out of there.
Yo, I warned Lamar Odom on Twitter like 5 years ago. Bro.
No, but seriously, it's in her best interest.
It's in my archive. I said, get out of there, bro. At real Lamar Odom. And he didn't listen to
did me. You really?
Yes.
It's in
I
her,
remember why. Something happened.
But real talk, it's at this current time, it's in
get out
her,
of there, James.
It's in her best
French.
Interest to act as if, even feign as if she cares about him, right? Because she don't want him blowing up. There's nobody. I think Rob Kardashian want to be out the help. Want to be out the family.
The brothers don't go on TV that much. They're like,
The brother's like, nah, because he know how messy the family is, how a group of women is. And so I think, particularly for Lamar, he's like, I don't know what to do. So at this point, Chloe's like, let me be there for him. Let me support him. Let me feed him applesauce or whatever else so that if he does get better, he doesn't tell our secrets. Because I can then say, like, but I was down for you. I helped you when you ain't had nobody. I put you on my medical insurance because that's purportedly why they stopped the divorce proceedings so that he could then go on her insurance.
Wow.
I think they're attempting to do that as hush money. I think it's good for him, but I want it to
come
out.
She got more money than he does
right now. Yeah.
At this point.
So it's not so much.
At this point, but she got a lot of his money. You know, they had like something in their prenup where if it was a certain amount of years, I want to say 5 years or less, then she stood to gain X amount of money. If there was any cheating, I want to say it was millions of dollars that she stood to gain. Each year that they were married, she gained more and more money.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
They that's a mess. They a hot ass mess. I
weird
said it here
that
first.
No one really attacked her for not being there in the beginning.
No, they did though.
They weren't attacking like they was attacking. Like people was coming out like, yo, how come Kobe ain't dead? Like, the fuck is Kobe supposed to
well,
like,
I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna tell you.
But people was going at Kobe like.
I'm gonna say this. It was P who did it, and you know I've been. All throughout the show, I've been talking about how messy. I thought it was messy of him. I think he was trying to talk and just be like very open with like his feelings or whatever else. But it was because there was another big name celebrity that went after Kobe. Otherwise, somebody would have thought about like, why isn't Kobe there for Lamar? It wasn't that. It was that Master P like surfaced that energy,
yeah.
And as a result,
it was all
started
small,
to
it was
question.
All, yeah, it was all those like.
It was bad.
Type of sense.
That wasn't right, P.
Kobe did everything.
You better than that, P.
There's only so much you can do.
Right.
But at the same time, Lamar Odom willingly went into that situation.
He did.
And did not heed my advice.
That's right. That's
and he stayed there. What can you do? I'm sure Kobe gave his 2 cents. Like,
right.
Yo.
Don't be messing with them.
Get out of there, dog.
Messing with sex houses with them drugs, bro.
That was bad. That was such a bad look. And Dennis Hoffman, though. Dennis Hoffman, he is the slimiest of slime. So he got on several, like, news outlets. Breakfast Club, Nancy Grace. He wanted to tell her. I think he was on Wendy Williams. Calling in, he was like, let me show you the two women, right, that he was with. It was these trashy-ass women. I'm telling you, people that looked like they was on the street corners of 5th and K. Transvestite-looking women. And that's when
no shots at Chloe.
No shots at Chloe.
Maybe he got type. Well, that's another thing that
maybe
was
he
like
him with
in,
broad shoulders.
That was in the media as well, though, that he had actually talked about adding another woman. Now, Dennis Hoffman, who I don't trust, he had produced some paperwork that says that Lamar Odom wanted a third woman who was a transvestite, and they were
what?
Only in negotiation.
Paperwork. What kind of place is this? They got paperwork for that.
It's a real brothel.
Have
it
you
was
not
in the
seen
Pimps
that?
Up, Hoes Down movie. You know what I'm saying?
There. Wait, it's on
that's
HBO.
The, that's the
it's
cat house.
The cat, yeah, the cat house. Have you watched it on HBO?
Wait, was he in Nevada?
He was in Reno, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Then,
so
yeah,
you can pick
look.
Your flavor,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, oh, yeah. I didn't know he was in.
He wanted to doubt it.
And so he had two women. Actually, he had contracted these women for an entire week. Two women.
Yeah, that's a lot of bread.
It was $70,000. Apparently, because he never paid, Dennis Hoffman told Khloe and the rest of the Kardashians, you better pay up. You owe us money. If that's still your husband, then you're on the hook or we're going to sue you. Like, that's just it.
My women need their paper.
That's real. He's a
paper. I need my cut.
He's a legal pimp. He really, really is.
Legal, too. Legal as pimp.
But my
he
point is
he might not beat Chris Jenner, though, in that pimp game. He might not win.
Well Chris done got, like, it's putting everybody on. I wouldn't be surprised if Northwest got a contract. Yeah, it's being managed now. Like, maybe. All those little tutu dresses and all these other pictures that are being shown up.
Did y'all see this thing with Northwest telling the paparazzi no pictures?
No pictures.
Oh, yeah.
That shit made me sad, yo.
Why? Because you don't want her picture taken?
They stay taking her pictures.
I don't want her to have to, like, live like that. She's
too late.
3 years old.
Too late.
That sucks, yo.
For who?
For her. She's a baby.
She ain't worried about it.
She was. She told
me no pictures.
She
said no pictures.
She was
Here's
stressed.
My thing. Here's my thing. There,
you can't be stressed out of 3 year old.
No. But, like, at the end of the day, there are going to be many luxuries that Northwest is affording because of who she is. Yeah. And if your downside is you got some pictures being taken, I just don't know. No, like, I hear you. I hear you. That's it's like cool. Pick your poison. But she also ain't that kid in the hood that can't afford ballet. That happened going to ballet every day.
True. That's true.
Living her life.
Because Kanye's like, you gonna learn all these arts.
I'm telling you.
Kanye, you know that every art.
Let me be honest. I tried to do ballet. We couldn't afford it back in the day. I never realized my full potential as a ballet, you know what I mean, dancer, because we couldn't afford it. Northwest gets to afford it. So I
you would have traded the ballet lessons for, like, people all in your goddamn face all day.
Maybe. I can't tell now. I can't tell now because look at my life. I work hard. Northwest won't ever have to work hard a day in her life if she doesn't want to.
But everybody's struggle is different.
That's what I'm saying.
Struggle is relative.
It's very relative. Pick your poison. I'm
she
saying.
She picks. You don't have a choice.
Oh, well.
And they
Well, you know what I mean? Like, Northwest will never have to she'll never have to think about, like, what does it feel like not to eat? What does it feel like to be, like, you know what I mean, not have clothes? There are certain, like, struggles she ain't never got to feel. Sure. Yes, she will feel like, what does it feel like to have people in my face all the time? Well, fuck. Okay, feel it. Well, like, I don't know.
I do like to compare her. Not compare her, but it's interesting to see her grow up that way. And Blue Ivy, like, I don't, like, first of all, we rarely see Blue Ivy.
Boom.
And she don't even have to say no.
Right.
She might not even know how to say that yet, the real
talk. You safeguard your kid's childhood.
I don't know if it's safe. I want to know.
Beyonce's like, no.
But here's what they say, particularly about the, like, Kim Kardashians of the world. I've heard that it's like certain stars calling up paparazzi saying, yeah, we're going to be at this location. Yeah. There are certain restaurants that they go to in California that they're infamous for having paparazzi stake out. That being said, I don't know if it's Blue Ivy, like, you know, a factor of her parents just choosing to be more private.
Well, her parents have real talent.
I hear you, but what I'm saying is
they can get attention by being talented.
I'm not sure that it's a factor of, like, you know, Northwest saying she, you know, she's constantly being stalked by the paparazzi, or her parents calling the paparazzi, or her grandma, whatever you want to call it.
I mean, her mother and her grandmother, because you've seen the way Kanye acts in regards to paparazzi.
Right,
because he walks in the signs by accident, he's throwing, he's getting in court cases. Clearly,
I don't know.
He can get attention on his talent.
I think he could, but there's something about him and his.
He willingly got in there.
He willingly
got in there. Get out of there, yay.
There are some people.
Get out of there, Yeezy.
Like, I'm never going to be with a Kim Kardashian type. He's the type of person that's like, I'm going to be with Kim Kardashian. And
I'm
going to
take all this on.
I'm going to take it all on. And when she decides to have some type of salacious cover, I'm going to further publicize that cover. Yo. That doesn't strike me as a man who's like, let me keep a low profile. No. He like.
He willingly got in there.
This was $10.
He broke the net this time. Like, get the
fuck out
of here. I haven't
seen
this
just to see the concept in action.
Let me say. Right?
Yeah, it was $10 on Amazon. I was like, fuck it, I got $10. This is
one of my favorite tweets.
Sandwich and fries.
She could never get $10 from me. This bitch could never get $10 from me. In fact, the fact that I'm like going through this.
You're interested. She's a polarizing figure. She's a lightning rod.
She is.
You can't help but have an opinion.
It's a crazy idea to me.
They're
to make a book.
All publicity is good publicity is their mantra.
I just know heifers like this. I know Armenian, other type, mixed chicks.
No shots at the Armenians.
No shots at anybody, but I know these non-black ass girls that are like, I'm special because I'm other. Get the fuck out of here. Like, I just don't. It gets me angry. It gets me angry. As a chocolate girl, it's like, I gotta be doper than dope. But this heifer looking like she ain't slept in days. She looks cheap. She looks slutty. She looked like I could find her in the Bronx on the side of the street prostituting. And for whatever reason, she is super dope to people.
Because she's other. That's like, man, it's my dudes, man.
She's so herself.
That's my dudes, my peers that do that. They go, my girl is black
and
Chinese shit.
And we gonna have some babies with baby hairs that lay all the way down.
You bringing that out the baby
hair. Baby hairs. It's gonna be like one of those situations. And her eyes might be slanted.
Her hair wheel.
Get the fuck. Like, I can't.
Yo, man. I feel you, yo.
That's
so
funny.
I
like the baby hair.
And here's my thing. This heifer ain't got real hair, real eyelashes, real nothing either.
Real so cakes?
Hello? Ain't got no real ass, no real breasts. So the fact that you guys look at this as like what is supposed to be exemplary, and it's supposed to be like, I need a other chick because she's all of these other things,
but she really ain't
all these other things. It's preposterous. And you guys may be the anomaly, but I'm telling you, if I had a dime for every single time somebody said Kim or another other light girl was like dream girl because they wanted babies with baby hairs that lay down, I'd be a rich
but
ass
that's,
woman.
Yeah, that's changing though because of her.
Know.
We need her because now that is changing.
I don't know either.
If you look at the younger ones, Kylie and them, like people don't fuck with that. They like when she comes with these collagen dot lips.
Who don't?
People don't. She gets backlash for that when she comes out with the like twerking and all that.
Says her 4.6 million followers. Who does not?
But she's
not says Tyga.
Follow.
Not says Tyga.
A follower.
The Kylie thing is actually to me is like literally one of the saddest things I've watched in the last 18 months. First of all, a rapper. A grown ass man.
He's a fucking weirdo though.
Left his wife, black
his child, girlfriend.
His girlfriend. Baby mama though, right? He got a kid with her, right?
Baby mama.
He left her to hang out with a girl that was in high school and to have a relationship with her that was not only condoned by her parents, one of which was going through a transition from one identity to another.
But you know,
she was busy.
You know who Tyga is, though.
But
Tyga is the nigga next to White Iverson in that video.
But also, like,
Tyga's the entry
that,
pass.
There's that other, like, rappers was like, when Kanye was like, that is cool. Like, he put it early. I'm like, bruh, 30. That is like molestation on like the
yo.
But like, let
that
me tell
is
you,
terrible grooming.
I want to be honest though, like Julian. To be honest, and we got to keep it all the way real. I can't with Tyga far before that, right?
Way
so he met Black China,
yeah,
and even though
point,
Black
no point ever,
even though Black talk. China though, even though Black China is a black woman. The fact that you met somebody at the strip club, you
Drake.
Wanted to wife her, right?
Drake.
You had a baby with, like, it's one of those situations where, like, you.
Like a sauce walker for me, too.
I mean, honestly, you place value and importance on the things you want to. I'm never going to have a man like Tyga because you got to like an intellectual to want to be with me. The fact that he likes the stripper and I'm going to wife her, it's not super far from wanting a 17-year-old that has notoriety and is popular. I don't think that that's like, so that's why I wasn't surprised by Tyga. Everybody holding him to this high esteem, I don't get it. He ain't never shown good judgment before.
No,
I was just more shocked that everybody was okay with it. Like, she's literally a child.
Who was okay with it?
Okay.
Her family? The other people
around
her?
Look at that
like, yo, like.
They don't have no morals. It's about publicity.
The fact that you would let your 17-year-old, though, this is real talk. The fact you let your 17-year-old be in magazine shoots with no clothes on, whatever else, you're not trying to protect their innocence. It's not about that. It's like, I'm sure Kris Jenner was somewhere like, you know what I mean? Like the evil chemist, right? Like super excited. This is what I imagine. Super excited by the fact that the story about her daughter, Kylie, and Tyga, like that story blowing up was like, oh, she got a number of hits because of this. She probably appreciated the notoriety that Kylie and Tyga was getting. She was like, oh, this just means she's going to be an even bigger star than Kim.
Right.
I'm waiting for the sex tape. Kylie and Tyga's sex tape. Tell me when that leaks. Matter of time. No, tell me when that leaks.
It's horrible.
I can't deal with that.
That's why families need fathers, yo. None of this would have happened if Robert didn't die.
Oh, well, yeah.
Well, Robert wasn't her dad. She's just a father. Right. Yeah, yeah.
None of this would happen
if Chris she might not have existed if Robert had that shit.
None of this would happen if Bruce ain't died.
I'm still not convinced that Chloe.
Rest in peace, Bruce.
Shut up. I can't
get out of
because
there,
I respect
them.
I respect Caitlyn.
Caitlyn is doing
I respect the transgender movement. This is what I'm concerned about. Well, I'm not concerned. You still can't convince me that Chloe is actually Robert Sr. That Chloe's actually
his daughter.
You can't convince me. When I saw that girl's coarse ass hair, I was like, one of these things doesn't look like the other. The rest of them is 5 foot. This heifer is 6'2". Are you serious?
OJ smash or nah?
Honestly, I'm not gonna put it on OJ, but tell me why this girl is getting keratin treatments, which means she's getting perms. Everybody else hair looking like one way, this girl looking like Kizzy when her hair is not straight. Why you looking like Celie when your hair ain't straightened? Where does that come from? What part of the lineage is that? You can't tell me otherwise.
Yeah, I don't know.
I never thought about it before, but I...
Have you seen her hair like when she don't...
I've never paid them any real attention, so no.
This girl hair look like she is from the motherland. Like she grew up in the sub-Saharan African desert.
Like, to be honest, like she looks like her mom's or she looks her sister's, but I don't know if she really looks like Robert Kardashian.
I'm telling you, this hair texture. And that's it. Tell me why your two sisters, your older sisters, are 5 foot... One. You all of a sudden 6'2", in addition to the fact that your hair is as coarse as Nigerian hair. To quote Mr.
Julian podcast. I'm just saying though.
What?
You can get his podcast shut down.
Holiday, a glass of ocean slipping down. My front and landing on my hopes I'm dreaming. Off the maps, no hidden grids, I'm fleeing. I worship you like holy days, lying on my back, seeing clouds and rays, drinking lime and bitter from my lemonade. White horses every time won't do.
No shots at the Armenians.
No shots at the Armenians.
No shots at anybody. I just don't like tramp ass women.
They have mad shots at Drake though. And at White Iverson, whoever he was.
Post Malone.
No, you didn't like Little Dicky.
Malone didn't even play in the post.
It was Little Dicky who had gone.
He didn't like Post Malone either.
Shots at Little Dicky too.
He like
Little Dicky too.
He was like, yo, fuck that, post Malone. That money.
Pick and roll Malone. Shots at you too. White Iverson.
Who do I want to throw shots at? You know, I actually kind of like Chloe if she being real. The Kims, the Kylies. Oh, I didn't know this picture was taken. Oh my gosh, my left nipple is out. Like, that right there will get me super angry because it's, as much as people want to say about, like, the Amber Roses of them, she is who she is. And she has never claimed to anybody. She's never claimed to be anything but a, a former stripper,
she's a bird,
a former whatever. That's my thing. You want to do your slut walk? Do your thing. You want to talk about like, oh, I don't know how that picture got into the internet. That tape, what? But then we see that you are generating millions of dollars worth of revenue. Bitch, you know how it got into the internet and you're profiting off of it. Accept it. That's my problem.
The first time I heard you say bitch, so this is definitely
I'm like drunk, so I curse a little bit more.
Definitely one.
My money, like, my mouth is so potty when I drink. But anyways, you get what I'm saying. Bitch. I have such a potty.
You are so classy, right? My mouth is so potty.
Honestly, it's potty, but...
All you car bitchians.
No, but it's not even all of them, because I feel like Kendall... The one who's modeling across, you know, in Europe and stuff like that.
She got the cosign. She got all the cosign from the houses. And be like, we love Kendall.
She the one that's with D'Angelo Russell?
I think she's dating people. I don't know.
No, she's dating, like, one of the Jonas Brothers.
Dating D'Angelo Russell from the Lakers.
I don't know. Here's my thing that I like about her.
Kendall's been seen with a bunch of different people. But
she's been seen. Here's my thing. It's not that I think that she's
on Kim track.
I don't think she's...
Maybe not. She might not be really doing it. She got to walk too many walks. She's
how many
too
many fashion shows.
Listen.
How many they got?
It's five.
A number. Years. Here's my thing, though. This is what I want to, like... No, she's not.
I mean, she's a 19-year-old. She's the one.
I want to differentiate. Like, I don't mind, like, somebody being seen. She should and can date whomever she wants to. My thing is, she actually has talent, right? So she done got her ass on the runway. She's been, you know, in fashion shows, Versace, Bauman, like reputable people, and she done made her money. Victoria's Secret, she got a good walk. She do her little thing. That's fine. I have a problem when you got these heifers like the Kylies, right? Who has an app. She's decided to have an app where she talks about, I like orange popsicle flavored lip gloss. Like that, like, bitch, I don't care what you
she's
like, right?
Bad lip
she
gloss.
Is
selling.
A teenager, bitch.
This girl 18 years old.
She
is an adult right now.
She ain't adult enough to date Tiger. You got a problem with that?
She's 25 years old. She better get with it. Jesus, she better get grown. She ain't doing childlike things.
Oh, no.
She doing grown woman things.
She's in her own house.
Wait for the tape to come out.
I hope that don't happen. I mean, I ain't gonna watch it.
You know, that would kill that completely.
Did you watch the R. Kelly tape? This is how I know when people nasty. Did you watch the R. Kelly tape?
It came out, yeah.
You did?
Oh. This is before the internet.
This is a long ass time. You had to watch the actual R. Kelly tape.
It was a tape.
Yeah, it was an actual tape.
Like, people bought that on the street, was like, yo.
But you had to come up with
it. They were selling it in Chicago.
You had to come up with an opinion, so I saw enough to be able to say, no, that's not R. Kelly.
No.
That was it.
It was
R. Kelly.
That was all I saw was enough to say that's not R. Kelly.
That was that nigga.
Did you watch the Kim K tape?
I saw a little bit of it.
I didn't see.
Because that was the internet era. That was the, like, you could just click and download. See, the R. Kelly era.
I just heard it wasn't worth watching, so I never watched.
Yeah, it's not. From what I saw, it's boring. But the R. Kelly thing was just like.
She tried to do a little something. She tried to do a trick. Listen now. Okay.
No shots at the Armenian girls. We know y'all putting it down in the building.
Do you know that?
That's what I hear.
Do you know that for a fact?
I'm going to ride with the
assumption. I'm ride with the
homies. Right, right.
I'm
going
to ride with the homies.
Why? Because she got because she the other and she got purse lips. And so, like, the other seemed like she might. I don't
come down super hard on them. Like,
oh, okay.
They're trying to misappropriate our bedroom skills.
Oh, so you're going to say she...
Sure. Good for y'all. Get it in.
Good for y'all. I'm just saying...
You ain't doing nothing but being a walking advertisement for Armenian girls putting it down.
Yes, he's
and good. It is in direct conflict with what you said earlier.
About what?
That you weren't that guy. I'm not that guy that cares, like, misappropriates and thinks about women in that way, that cares about the other. And you just said, you don't know these girls.
I'm not going to put it down.
And you didn't watch the video.
I did.
To appropriately be able to say if she did or not. Oh, lazy ass Kim K. Do better, Kim K. You gonna put out another tape? Do better. Get involved.
Kanye.
I wasn't going to sign.
Get involved.
To the whole
Kanye for the whole.
And I'm gonna say, Kim K. Ray J deserved better.
Kanye for
than your last lazy ass. That's
Kanye
what I'm saying.
Kanye put out no tape. He ain't about to.
I didn't see it.
She was hella lazy.
That's what I heard.
She was hella lazy. She said, "I'm gonna rely on these fake eyelashes. Let me bat them 2 times. Okay. Now I'm gonna rely on." It doesn't matter. I didn't see the tape.
It was boring. I saw 5 minutes was boring as hell.
I saw it. It was more than 5 minutes, but what I'm saying is I just thought it was super lazy, and it only confirmed my suspicions about other girls relying on certain talents, fake eyelashes, light skin, baby hair is laying down, to then, I don't know, capture the attention of men. It wasn't based on actual talent. It was based on you being other.
Let me ask you this question, because people talk about how black people...
Talent. I like how that is a classy way to say, like,
talent,
yo,
that's you nice in the
bedroom. You ain't got the talent.
I'm not even trying to be like even hypersexualizing this. Yeah, I hope you understand that. I'm just being honest.
People talk about how black people accept the stereotypes we want to accept, and that's one of them. Like being good in the bedroom, that's one that we just keep. Like, is that cool?
Particularly
for like black girls, like, is that cool?
I'm not saying anything about, you know, other versus black girls. And I hope that this podcast, I am a woman that's interested in unifying other women. I have friends who are of all different nationalities. That's not my point. The point is when we try to act as if there is one type of nationality, race, other mixture, whatever, that is better than the other based on stereotypes. That being said, many times we automatically assume that others, or light skin, long hair, or whatever else, we automatically assume that they are of dominant anything, right? So they are all of a sudden, perhaps they have superhuman powers. I tell you one thing, and this might be, let me tell your podcast, I'm a chocolate girl, right? So I get this. I often come in contact with men and like women who believe that there are certain women who have, I'm telling you, messed up facial features, right? So like, you know that there are certain like dimensions and dynamics of a face that like are known to show or indicate physical attractiveness.
Yeah.
Those folks don't have those things. I'm telling you, could be just like disfigured in the face. But if they're light skin, all of a sudden that puts them a notch above whatever disfiguration that they may have because they are light skin.
They're light skin.
It's colorism.
Yeah.
I'm not even, and it sounds, I know people think like, okay, that's that hater ass, like chocolate girl syndrome. It's really not.
Rolling in, right?
Comments rolling in. It's the hater ass chocolate girl syndrome, but it's really not. I'm telling you, I've had men that say, that will look at me in my face.
Say, cute for a dark skinned girl.
Cute for a dark skinned girl. Like,
I can't believe people say that.
People do say that.
Shame on all you niggas.
No. They'll say you're cute for a dark skinned girl, or they'll look at me like, and they'll look in like closer. And I've had this one guy. This doctor goes, you have really pretty facial features. And it's
he's surprised.
And it's one of those things where it's like, if I hadn't looked at your actual face, I might have just been taken aback by the fact that you're chocolate and just thought that you was like Sealy. But now that I actually look at you, you're kind of dope. Sealy, a little bit of a hot mess. She ain't well put together. That's just what it is. It ain't like, you know what I mean? It is what it is.
Well, especially if you go in the whole thing in the story, like, you know, she was like called ugly by Mr. and all that fucking shit.
Yeah.
She'll come in,
shook a little lighter, shake it a little bit.
Yeah. Everybody loves shit, though. Like, shook and sick. Her daddy wasn't happy with her.
My point is I don't want to be that girl that is like, there are a lot of beautiful women who are light skinned, who are of the other variety. That's not my point. My point is to say is when you say that there are ugly women who, because they are light skinned, have all of a sudden become beautiful, that's my issue. Or when they're beautiful chocolate girls, but because they're chocolate, they're not as pretty. Like, I got an issue with that. And I think it's the same thing. Like, leave your ass for a white girl. It happens quite often. So, like, yeah, because you're light-skinned, you may be the next thing close to white. And so you may get that basketball player that's not as socially conscious. But, like, if there's something better, if there may be a white girl, if they family okay with a white girl, he gonna leave your ass, too. So, take that into consideration as well.
I mean, that's the oldest time, though. That ain't just our culture. That's a whole lot of cultures. Got that colorism going on.
It's going
on
a long time here.
Ain't no wrong with it. Love who you love. And that's why I've dated the UN, because I'll always love who loves me. Like, and it's not going to be a situation where I'm like, I'm not going to date white men, or I'm not going to date Filipino men or whatever else. Like, I'm going to be like y'all. Black men. I'm going to get it how I live.
Ain't no wrong with that.
Hello.
The fight dog say, I like them brown, Puerto Rican, and Asian. Probably fight dog from the Zulu Nation.
Yo, I only date white chicks my whole life. Because I got to talk to you. And I talk about mad black shit.
Who knew though?
You gotta understand.
It's not until this hat though went a little higher, a little more to the side than we even realized that this was like he was urban.
Yo, he was urban by the way you talk.
Exactly. People that talk to me. I talk a lot of black shit, so you gotta talk that black shit with me.
Side of the room, brown skin girl staring with the brown eyes. Ooh, baby, don't you know you're a cutie pie? Princess little honey with a polka dot dress on.
Nothing I said about these fucking white rappers. Yeah. If you gotta cut yours out, just play my part again. Just for extra emphasis. Fuck out of here, Post Malone.
Lil Dicky, we ain't for you.
You go back
in. Okay. Post Sam Perkins. We not fans of you over here. Post Randolph, like just random power forwards. We not a fan of you over here.
Oh, that's funny.
I just don't want to be too divisive on your show. Like, I want you to maintain your followers.
You have no idea of some of the shit we be talking.
You gotta keep it 100, man. That's the only way they gonna know.
Like, yeah, this is actually kind of par for the course, you know.
Is there anything else you wanted to capture?
Yes. On Julian's most recent episode, he had a good friend on. He talked about how he mentioned it. He talked about it. He said he was having issues with females. And me and Julian talk like quite a bit. We chop it up, but never really get into that, right? And then his homie was like, yeah, like what? He was like, man, I don't even want to talk about it.
Like what?
I was like, damn, what's going on with Julian? What's going on, bro? Hard in these streets, man. These DC streets.
I guess.
DC dating is some other shit. There's some shit out that's different from any other dating I've done.
DC.
Are you in a relationship?
No. I'm rarely ever in a relationship.
Okay. How long was your longest relationship, if you don't mind me asking?
Maybe a month.
Wow, okay.
What?
Yeah.
Damn. When was that?
Maybe like a year ago? A year and a half ago?
Okay. What type of girls do you like?
Smart ones.
Yeah?
Yeah. Ones that challenge my mind.
What do they call it? You're a sapiosexual.
I'm not totally a sapiosexual.
That shit ain't real.
I have certain, you know, physical things that I like. I have certain physical attributes I like.
Like what? You like big girls?
No.
Watch out for the big girls.
Well, like this.
Will you put that in there? Watch out for the big
girls. That would be more close.
Yeah.
Shouts out to the big girls, girl.
Watch out for the big girl.
Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Big girl. Big 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 big girl. Big girl. Watch out for the 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 big girl.
That's you know, I'm gonna tell you why it shocks me, because you are interested in your health. So I don't
see. I mean, I still want you to be healthy.
But you like big girls.
Yes.
Well, that's not that surprising, because I know a lot of skinny dudes that like big girls.
Yo, thank you for the compliment, brother. Thank you for the compliment.
I'm like, yo, I'm an overweight I'm an overweight dude. So like,
I probably got
you. So what's your type of girl?
Pretty.
What's pretty to you, though?
Yeah. Yo.
Because here's the thing. It's like, I guess because I've been drawn for so long, there's certain things that I go for.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, I even analyze it. Like, there's a certain level of attractiveness go for how symmetrical a person's face is.
Yeah.
So, like, I know that. So, I can tell, you can tell, like, okay, cute eyes, cute nose. Like, just, I don't know, generally aesthetically pleasing. Like, I like pretty girls. I just, sometimes it could be certain factors, like eyes. I'm more about the face more than everything else.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, some dudes is like, yo, the blah, 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 is, you know, booty right.
The bladder.
You know, okay. When it says some people is breasts, some people is legs, some people is ass. I'm like, all that's great. I do like a good figure. Like, if I ain't messing with the face, though, like, I can't wake up in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
If I ain't gonna be like, I can sit down and just look at you for a long time, because I draw stuff for this, so I can just like stare at a person, look at a person for like a long ass time.
Mm-hmm.
And looking at people is my shit. I probably look like a creep all the time sometimes on the metro, because I just look at people.
You look at people at work too.
I know I do.
You like really zone in.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's certain things. Might be like a feature.
I've noticed that.
Like, it's different. Like, you know, I like different types of hair. I do like long hair, though. I ain't gonna lie.
Who's your ideal? Like, is there a famous woman who's your
That's
ideal?
That's a good question.
Because I can tell you mine.
Yo.
It's like, I like to do it.
Rosario Dawson. She fine as hell.
She is.
Yeah.
She is.
Huh. I think she has masculine features.
She does. She can be goofy.
She does.
And fine at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
That's what you want.
She's smart. I gotta feel challenged.
Mm-hmm.
It come at it from different way. Cause like some people think like, oh man, he probably goes for like a geek person. Like, nah, I'm into that.
Those chicks though,
I know that shit.
Do tend to be like kind of geeky on the low. Like they're the chicks that like have layers that you wouldn't necessarily expect.
Yeah, I like well roundedness. I like to be able to talk about random stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I don't always like to have to like explain things though. Like if I'm going to always explain something, I want to learn something too. Cause I guess I'm getting to this age where I'm always showing somebody something or explaining some shit to somebody. I guess that's what happens when you start getting to a point where you post 35, get that knowledge. I'm just saying.
You feel like you're set in the way in your ways as well, being 35.
Not really.
Okay.
Like, you're willing to learn.
Yeah.
Willing to explore. So what were you going through at the time that long exasperated sigh came out? You came with nigga.
Yeah, I don't know.
What was going on that day?
Sometimes it's weird, because sometimes you just get cut off and you never know why you get cut off. Like, you never got that far. But, like, so what is the reasons why you stopped interacting with me? Sometimes you never find out.
Yeah.
Do you ever ask?
Don't ask.
You can ask, but you're never gonna get, you might not get an answer.
I think that's important though. If somebody were to ever ask me, and I feel like people have, like, I'd give them the benefit, the courtesy of answering the question. The same way I want to have it too, right? But like, when you date, like, that's exactly the purpose for dating. You decide, you figure out, like, what works for you, what doesn't. And then, like, you hope that somebody may, you know what I mean?
Sometimes the answer
may be impassioned enough to allow you to...
But sometimes it's not, like, articulable. Like, you can't really put it into words sometimes because it's like a feeling.
I don't know that. I think it's... When someone tells me they can't put things into words, it tells me that they're lazy. You can always put something into words, right? If it's that I just didn't get a good vibe from, fill in the blank, right? That is putting it into words. You telling me you can't put it into words is like, again, evidence of laziness in that you don't want to think long enough. I mean, two reasons. A, you don't want to think long enough to be able to put it into words. Or B, like, you don't want to tell me. But it's not a factor of not knowing. And if you don't know why you're doing something, then I have to think, like, that's dumb. Stupid.
But that's not, if you just say, I didn't get a good vibe, that's not saying anything. That's can't.
I think it depends on how long you're interacting with the person. If there's a long period of time and things just change randomly,
I don't know about time, but progression. Like, if it was a long period of time, y'all was texting once a week, that's not really...
Let me tell you why. Anything. Number one, a grown woman... Well, I'm not going to speak for all grown women. I also don't want to put things on folks, but, like, the whole texting all the time, that is so lazy. It's so lazy. You don't get to know people from texting.
No, you don't. I agree.
So the point of it saying, like, that shows me I want to put in minimal effort and I want to see what may come from this little bit of effort that I'm going to give you. Like, let me give you my crumbs. It's the most ridiculous thing ever.
I also might be a little bit too nice.
In what way?
I'm kind of...
You're a giver?
Yeah.
I just feel like the woman that's for you, like, number one, I always think it's interesting when people take advantage of nice people because to me that shows who you are, right? It's not evidence of like, oh, that means Julia needs to be like a more whatever person. Right. The right woman for you is gonna be like, this man is so nice. And because he's so nice, I can't even think of wanting to take advantage of him. That's how I feel about nice people. It's like, it doesn't give me like the grounds or whatever to be like, damn, I can do X, Y, and Z to him. I know that if you're intuitive enough, you know the potential power that you have over certain people. But if you're a good person, you know not to use that power. You know what I'm saying? So I always think that's so messed up when people say like, ooh, I know he, if I asked him for it, he'd give me X, Y, or Z. If you're a good person, you're not even gonna ask for it unless you need it, you know? So, I just think that's a reflection of the person.
Yeah, in the right situation, you'll get it back. Like, you don't ever stop giving, but you'll give it to a person who readily give it right back to you. So, it's not about you being too nice. It's just about the target of your niceness, of your generosity.
Yeah, you'll give it right back, or that person doesn't take it as a sign of weakness. I've heard so many times, particularly like in my female friends, ooh, but he's just such a nice guy. And I'm thinking like, okay, if there's like a super nice guy and I'm not interested in him, I'm not going to let him do things for me. Point blank, period. Because I know that you may be nice to me because you're looking for something more. If I'm not interested in that something more, I need to have self-control, like the right amount of self-control to say, thank you so much for like wanting to look out for me, but I can't let you do it. That to me is being like the right type of person. The type of female that will take advantage of that and want to have like the benefits of your niceness, but not want you. Like, that's a grimy ass woman. Like, it's not like at this age, like, it's not cool, especially for women that can do for themselves. Like, there's nothing I need from you. So like, if for instance, if you ask me out on a date and you're like, I want to take you out for dinner, and I'm not in shit, K-Sade, and I'm not interested in you, it's not appropriate for me to let you purchase my, or let you, you know what I mean, buy my food.
Yeah.
I will just as soon say, like, no, let's split this. Let's go Dutch or whatever else. Because I think that's what's appropriate. That's you exercising self-control to say, I'm not trying to get over on this man. There are far too many women that are like, ooh, he's nice. He'll give me a free meal. That's ridiculous. Particularly if you're of a certain, like, you know what I mean, income where you don't need a free meal. That's just, you're just grinding, trying to take advantage of a situation.
Yeah.
I'm not for it.
Tell them, yo.
Like, I mean, what really is the value of a free meal?
But here's the thing. Like,
that's on the ladies. But y'all men on something else, too.
Yeah, I ain't
gonna lie. Y'all know some shit,
too. It's hard out here, man, on both sides.
I can't.
Yeah, okay.
I'd rather be on my side, but it's hard out here on both sides.
Like, I can't speak on any other guy. I notice what some of them do. I shake my head at them. I be like, you're gonna catch it eventually. But it's just weird. Like, I don't understand, like, sometimes the whole nice being a detriment, being a bad thing. It's like, why? Because I know there's sometimes men who are being nice for ulterior motives.
Definitely.
Oh, my gosh.
But
listen,
I mean, there's a balance.
Listen.
You don't want to be a doormat.
Yeah.
There's a balance. Nobody wants you to be a doormat. You don't want to be a doormat.
You don't want to be a doormat, but why can't we get to the point, and I'm not just saying, like, in black relationships, I wish we could, but, like, where people ain't on that. Like, I want to do for you, and you want to do for me just because, like, we are down for one another.
Don't worry.
It's not... Why not,
nice,
though?
It'd be nice.
Why not? It would, right? Like, I can't
you
with it.
Understand,
like,
the point.
Being in a relationship for the last year and a half, like, it is just... The thought of, like, starting over, the thought of, like, now having to go back through, the rat race of figuring out somebody's true intentions, I'm telling you, that's the worst part of it all. Because to me, it's like, it's not, like, why can't we build a partnership where we both winning? Like, I don't understand why we would even spend time in, like, the trivial things of trying to compete or figure out one another,
yeah,
when it's like us against the world. We gotta compete against and figure out the other shit. Like, ain't nobody got time for the rest.
But yeah, you gotta understand what's been ingrained in us, particularly black people.
I don't care. We gotta get over that.
Yeah,
we gotta get over that. Like,
but
it's
that's
not
work.
The work.
That's work.
Why is it though?
Because the society has taught us win at the expense of the next person, even the next person is your mate.
I can't buy into that.
I think that's a new concept.
I can't buy into it.
I think that's a post civil rights era,
yeah,
concept.
Yeah.
Cause my goal,
cause when we were all down,
is to have Heathcliff and Clint Huxtable lifestyle. That's all I want. I saw that shit when I was like 4. I was like, older I get, like, yeah, that's the, yeah. I don't care about Bill Cosby the person, but when that image on television, how Clay Huxley was like the jam, yeah.
And my thing
and
is
it was
this,
just straight partnership all the way.
It's straight partnership, but the idea too, and I see a lot of people like, oh, I want this type of relationship. The idea is that you may not be there right now. I am not at my pinnacle right now. Whoever my mate is likely not at where they want to be. Like, the Michelle and the Baracks right now at our age are still forming. They are still yet to be. The idea is that we don't have to do this thing separately. There are things that, like, let us complement each other, and I'm going to help you get there. You help me get there. We're going to build this together. That's why I don't understand why people work in silos in that way, because it just doesn't make any sense. We make life harder than it really needs to be. You know what I'm saying? By trying to operate individually.
Yeah.
Just doesn't make sense. Like, let's get this money together. Like, seriously.
But that's the conflict.
Because
we come from communal based worldviews, and now we're in an individualistic based society.
They bought into the wrong thing. Most people buy into the wrong part of
capitalism.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
The thing is, they take parts of capitalism, though. Like, they're not looking at all of it.
Exactly.
Like, if you want to compare yourself to, you know what I'm saying, the Joneses, if you want to compare yourself to the white families, the Asian families, Jewish families, the Latin families.
Yeah, they partner up.
Like, they take the L. They take the L.
I don't understand. So when we talk about, like, partnering up, it's like, I don't understand why black families don't feel this way in particular. We shouldn't have, like, we shouldn't have the same amount of we shouldn't be experts in the same thing, right? We don't have to be. Like, where can we find those points of intersection? Where can we complement one another? And then where can we grow, like, coalesce to be, like, the that ish, like, to be the shit together? I don't understand then why, like, you're talking about this capitalistic society and this and that. Like, why in the world do we feel like, as black women, black males, that we are competing for anything when most of the time we don't even want the same thing? Like, it's not like a matter of competition, a matter of money. We don't want the same thing.
Yeah, it's not always competition, but sometimes it could be a situation where you feel like tying yourself to this relationship holds you down, slows you down from the things you want to do as an individual. And that division was taught. That division was taught. Like, they pulled black men out the homes, put them in prison, put them on crack, because you could get, like, welfare benefits only if the man was not in the house. Like, all of that stuff was taught. And now we have to undo that and then build again.
But in that same way, though, and I understand how, like, some of that stuff is systemic, but in the same way, we're not all welfare recipients. What I don't understand is people in the, like, people who live in this area, right, who are not, like, benefactors of welfare or whatever, still have that mentality when they didn't grow up on welfare and they still are not functioning off of welfare.
So, yeah, think about it, right? They grow up with a dad in the home. Maybe not.
Maybe not. But here's my thing. It is, right, it's evil, but it's like, what we can achieve together. Like, I'm gonna tell you this, there is never, I don't understand, and this is just something, because I was not a relationship girl. I just became, like, a year and a half, I was not that girl. But my level of focus after being in a relationship, my ability to achieve certain things with a support system, not being out in these streets, like, that allowed me to achieve more and to have a more a better focus on the things I actually needed to get done. You get what I'm saying? So, like, for people to not see the benefit of that versus, like, being out in the streets, having this wandering mind, always looking for the next best thing, like, not having, there's even something in having, like, companionship where you ain't got no worries. You have the companionship you need. You have that ride or die, such that, like, if you have a rough day at work, that person is there for you. There are so many
to talk to,
right? To be your counsel, to have advice, to be a support system for someone who's not looking for anything else but your best interest in mind. Like, there's so much of a benefit in that, that, like, then will translate to, like, you being able to achieve the things you want to achieve. I can't see why anybody sees that as something that's, like, a takeaway. I don't get it.
Because they don't know no better. Like, I can't. It's like, I don't want... Because, like, I know, like, a lot of things, I just... There's certain things about dating or relationships, the way things work, I just don't understand.
That's
the
why...
The way in which, like, things are going, like, I don't... Like, I'm good with just having somebody that I can, like, hold their hand. I'll be good. Like, I'm old school, I guess. Like, I'm getting old now. Like, I don't care. I'm just chill.
Watch Marvel, not Netflix and chill, but actually just sit out and just chill and relax. Those are the best relationships, the ones you can just be in, relax. That's the only type of relationship though, in my opinion.
You know, learn something new, something I ain't up on. That's what I look forward to. Challenges,
but also
different type of intellectual. To, like, I don't know this, so put me onto this, or see something through somebody else's eyes.
The idea, though, particularly in D.C. that I find is that, like, we got to be on all the time. At work, I feel like I need to be on. I need to be, like, you know, quick, sharp, whatever else. You go out into, like, whatever other thing, these networking happy hours, whatever, in your friend group, sometimes you got to constantly be on. Be the most intelligent, most articulate, whatever else. I have to have a space in my personal life, like, in my personal time, my downtime, to be, like, off. to be goofy, to like drink, to sit down, have this podcast and be real. Like, if I can't have that with my significant other, I shouldn't be with that person. That's the idea. Like, you have to have, like, to just be.
Yeah, I've already started rejecting a lot of other stuff. Like, I go to them events. I go to events like this. I don't give a... Like, I don't care. I don't care. Like, I'll talk to you about Saved by the Bell. I'll amaze you with the awesomeness of Screech powers. I know all the intricacies of Screech.
And a girl that's for you is going to be like, he's dope.
I will see.
He's dope. I mean, you know what I mean? Like, that's the person that's for you.
We'll see.
That finds all your eccentricities, that finds all of that, like, super dope. That's what it is.
That's how it got to always be. Because if you want somebody living a lie, then you got to live that lie. Yeah. Like, you got to win them being yourself, being your complete, full self, so that y'all can just spend Tuesday afternoon together. And you don't have to just be on.
That's what I hope for you. I mean, because I know girls like that. So, like, it's interesting, too. And I will say this. Like, I don't want to be like I'm, like, matchmaker. But, like, at the end of the day, like...
Yeah, call them up right now.
I think about, like, people who want just, like... You mean DC in general, or just...
I don't know.
In these streets. Overall.
Yeah.
What do you find as far as, like, the dating? Like, tell me, what would be your one complaint about the dating scene in DC?
I don't know if I'm really good at talking about it, because I really don't try to date or go out that often.
Why is that, then? Like, how do you get to what you want if you don't do that?
I don't know. It's the always on thing, I think, that throws me off. Like, you're just saying, like, people are always on. Mm-hmm. It's like, if I'm saying you always X, like, I don't know how interested I'm going to be into that person. So the whole, like, oh, let's go out and do this, I don't know. Like, I need to see more. I need to see more before I even get interested. Mm-hmm. So, like, I'm a slow mover.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even, like, find people attractive for... Like, I find people attractive, but I don't find people interesting until after a while. Knowing them. Seeing them. You know, a watcher.
Yeah.
Sit back. I pay attention. That doesn't always work out, though.
Mm-hmm.
It is what it is.
Jeez, he's gonna be sober when he comes out, though. Jesus, ain't nothing left. Lord, have mercy. That's why I cut on the water, because I hate when people hear me when I'm using the bathroom. I cut on the water immediately. It doesn't matter what I'm doing. Like, cut on the water. Yeah.
Dating is weird.
It is.
Especially when you start getting older, it gets more tiresome and more
Well, because you're more set in your ways.
Oh, yeah, or you have different intentions sometimes.
Or, like, you know what you want. Like, I think sometimes it's harder when you know what you want as opposed to, like, when you're younger and you're like, I'll just date whatever. I'm just dating to see. Well, I mean, then that means, like, you've raised, like, you know, your level of expectation. You know what you want, so you can cut people out fairly quickly. And it means that you also, like, have a certain standard for what you are going to tolerate and what you're not.
Yeah. Yep.
I get it. I just, you're like, I get it. I'm, like, in a very similar situation because I'm trying to figure out, like, you know, on one hand, I have somebody that it's very difficult as to where we are. And, like, I've been noticing things that I just don't like. He talks about marriage, and I'm like, but for me, your actions don't match someone who I would want to marry. And so that is, like, in conflict of, like, am I really on, like, you know what I mean? Like, am I interested in going back and, like, dating? It's a tough-ass thing.
Yeah. In these streets.
The streets filthy.
These professional, too many professional people in one area of streets. Yeah. It seems taxing.
It's very taxing. I just feel like we got a lot of decisions, like, in everyday life that we have to make. And so, to the extent that this, like, last one, choosing who you want to spend time around, like, it ain't even got to be nothing serious, like, where it's like, this is the love of my life and this is who I'm going to marry. But, like, I enjoy spending time with this person. Like, to the extent that that can be, like, settled, like, why not just be happy for those things that you can control? You know what I mean? Unfortunate thing.
People want dreams, though.
Dreams, well, what do you mean by that?
I think sometimes people want these perfect things, these imaginary things they made up in their head.
You think people really want the perfect?
Yes. Because I think they've been sold the perfect.
Do you want the perfect?
Nah.
Because you didn't buy the perfect.
I rarely meet.
I don't want the chick that bought perfect.
I rarely meet people who really want the perfect at this age. At 25, perhaps, but 30, 35, like, years of dating shows you there is no perfect. So I rarely meet people our age who are like, I want the perfect. They're like, there are a couple of things that I value, and I value, like, super hard. Can I get those things? And the rest are negotiable. You want the perfect?
No.
Ain't nobody want that. People off that now. That's like the 25-year-old's dream.
I'd rather you not be perfect. Flaws are interesting.
I don't know if I mean perfect and, like, a perfect person, but I think they do have a certain idea of the way things they want to work. And it may not always come together.
Yeah, I think that people had a non-negotiable. So, for instance, what would be your non-negotiables? Like, I can't mess with a woman who what?
Smokes. Can't smoke.
I don't know. I gotta see out of who the person is.
So you don't even have, like, these kind of overarching non-negotiables. Nah, you are willing to set, like,
that's not, that could change. Like, every person is different.
Okay. That's like, fair.
Do I want a person that smokes? Not really. But I grew up around a house of smokers. If I really love the person, be like, yeah, you gotta do it outside, but That shit is expensive. I'm paying for them cigarettes, though.
That needs to come out your personal budget.
But, like, make that work. If that person will leave the bay.
Yeah.
So, it's just like,
you might not be being assertive enough.
That might be true, too.
Like, if you going, find, like people always say, like, finding love is a verb, right? Like, you have to actively find love.
Yeah.
It ain't gonna just fall in your lap on this couch. It's a nice couch, but it ain't gonna just fall in your lap.
Thank you. I did pick a good couch.
It is very nice. It's very comfortable as well.
It's a sleepable couch.
Yeah, it seems like it. Not for somebody like him, though. He's super tall. Like, his legs would fall over. Like me, I visualize myself like this. My legs crushed up.
Yeah. It's comfy for you ladies out there. Comfy space.
Right? Come on, come off.
He's mad hospitable.
And he got raspberry lemonade. And he has a plush bed that looks uber comfortable. Right. With plenty of pillows. Like, he got about 6 pillows up here.
And he got a guitar. Serenade you.
I ain't learned
to play yet. I don't know. You know enough.
Yeah, he got 3 chords. You got 3 chords or not right now?
I got 3 chords.
Sing you the finest of Ed Sheeran.
Yes.
On this couch. But you gotta find her first. You gotta invite her over here. She ain't gonna just stop by trying to borrow a cup of sugar. That don't happen in real life.
Nah, I believe it do.
No, man. Set yourself up to fail. You gotta get out here. I mean, these streets filthy, but you gotta be in them a little bit.
I think I'll just make some stuff. Making stuff worse till I'm ready again. Who knows? Not everyone's successful.
Many of us aren't.
Yo, that's so like defeated.
Not defeated. It's just it's like a state of just like a realist thing. Like, I don't believe anybody. Like, I don't believe I'm deserved anything. I'm owed nothing. Like, that's not the way life works.
That's one of those things I really remember about you. Like, yeah. Saying, like, I never say I deserve X, Y, or Z.
Yeah, you don't.
I think that's dope.
I mean, you're not owed it, but if it's out there, why not try to get it?
Yeah, you could try. Yeah, I'm just saying, I might not be successful.
You might not.
You know?
But your efforts will be rewarded. In some way.
Maybe. Well, yeah, rewarding is not always good, though.
It's not necessarily going to be good, but your effort will be fruitful.
And I think the other thing is, like, each kind of relationship or whatever situationship moves you a little closer to what you want.
Definitely. Because you got to figure out what you don't want.
You got to figure out what you don't want. You see, like, what you're willing to accept, what you're not. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, I'll meditate. I'll figure it out.
Yeah, you gonna find that girl that, I don't know, maybe Comic-Con. Shoot. She gonna be dressed up like Poison Ivy or something. I don't know.
I stay away from that. I don't want that in my life.
You don't want that? Why? Is that a Marvel character?
Nah.
Just checking.
We don't fuck with you, Marvel.
No, there's just certain things. It's just like, I need breaks from that type of stuff. Like, that combo stuff, I did it too long.
I
go back in it.
Like, so you want someone outside of that world?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
It's going to be something, like, atypical. Just draws you in, like you said, somebody from a different world than you from. That's what's going to keep y'all interested in one another.
Like, all this shit, I know all this shit backwards and forwards.
That's how I gotta go, though. You gotta step out your comfort zone. That's everything. That's the only way you're gonna grow is by stepping out of your comfort zone.
I can just be sad like my man Drake, though.
Fake sadness.
It's so interesting because he was like, he was super sad, and people was like, oh, he's sad. He's lame. The minute that he started, like, getting in the gym, buffing up, it was like, it didn't matter if he was lame, pitiful ass Aubrey. This man now has muscles and a goatee, and he hot. You know what I mean? It's so interesting. He's no longer lame.
He's still sad.
He is still sad, but he also has, like, he's a bearded man that has additional muscles, and women do not talk about him in the same way. They simply don't.
It's very interesting how much muscles do.
Muscles and facial hair.
Yeah.
Muscles and facial. I'm serious. Like, everybody has him as, like, MCM, da da da. Like, I thought he was, like, 2 years ago, I thought he was pitiful, broken, and, like, the cheesy ass man that like Nikki didn't want, that Serena didn't want, like.
Grow a beard, yo. Get in the gym.
He already got a beard.
A full, like a.
I can't do a full.
Drizzy beard.
I can't. I
got start it. Singing sad ass songs. And a.
With your guitar.
With my guitar.
And then lightly do a two step. I like two step.
Wear sweaters.
But not the full. It's not the full cha cha.
Not the full. No, 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 no. No, no, no. Just a light. You see, he ain't doing nothing full out. Just a light. Boop. Slowly.
Look like somebody uncle.
Yes. And a sweater and some sweatpants and some Timberlands, yeah.
I'm gonna show you really what this video is for me is him like showing how comfortable he is in his own skin. Yeah. The way that he never has. He gives no fucks. Like he does not care. And he's like, I know y'all thought I was lame, and I still am. And guess what? It does not matter. Y'all ain't talking about that no more.
This is how you dance when you're really comfortable.
When you just don't care.
Yeah.
And I can appreciate that. People always find it to be sexy or, I don't know, like attractive when you just don't care and you are yourself. That's the biggest piece of advice ever. And that's, I think, what the video indicates.
Drake dancing. I should title the episode Drake dancing.
Does not care. Like, this is like, it's the most awkward dancing kind of two-step. Like, really? What other rapper do you know that would sit here be doing a fake cha-cha for at least four scenes in a video in a block cube dance? Where else does that happen?
2 Chainz would do that.
He's another one that don't care. Right.
2 Chainz is too old to give a damn.
Right.
He's like, true.
Just doesn't care. I don't know. I like it, honestly.
I think this is a good ending point.
Fade out with the theme music. Mount Olympus by Big Crit.
No, I think it's gonna be that one.
That's actually one of my non-negotiables.
I'm a villain.